So in this video, I'm going to explain to you what you can do, what I can do, what we can do, so to say, to reduce the number of algae growing in our home aquarium, if you have one. So hi, hello, and welcome again. Microbehunter here. What you see here on the side is, these are some of the algae that I found in this this aquarium here. It's not a very happy looking aquarium, I have to tell you. The algae are really growing very strongly. Essentially, they're overgrowing the plants. The fish are not happy either, I can assume, because they don't have enough space, so they're gathering all in the little space that they have available in the corner of the aquarium. Everything else is overgrown, and this is something that, of course, also doesn't look very pretty, right? If you want to reduce now the number of algae growing in an aquarium, then you have to work on several levels at the same time. I struggled quite a bit reducing the number of algae in the aquarium, and I was not always very successful. Sometimes they kept on coming back, but there is essentially a couple of key things that you might want to try out and then maybe you're going to be successful. And I think one of the important things is that look at the density of those algae here. I mean, they can only grow like this if there are enough nutrients available. Of course, algae, just like plants, they do photosynthesis. They need carbon dioxide. They get this carbon dioxide from the fish, of course, a little bit also from the air that's bubbled through the aquarium, also from decomposition by bacteria, right? In the aquarium, there are many bacteria that break down the organic material, also releasing carbon dioxide. All of this, carbon dioxide can be used for photosynthesis. However, carbon dioxide alone is not enough, right? Because those algae, just like plants, they need other nutrients as well, phosphorus, nitrogen, and so on. And all of those additional nutrients, the algae and the plants obtain primarily when you feed the fish, right? So you feed the fish, and then the fish, they eat the food, and they produce wastes. And those wastes are those nutrients that the algae actually need. And what you have to do is you have to somehow reduce those nutrients. And the easiest way of doing that is simply by reducing the amount of food, at least for a certain time, the amount of food that you give to your fish. And this way, the fish will also start to eat the algae more because they're hungry, right? So you see that it has a double effect. On one hand, you're reducing the nutrients that you're adding to the aquarium. And on the other hand, the fish will start eating away more and more of these algae. Now, I have to tell you the following. If you just look at those algae that are growing on here, these are diatoms growing on filamentous algae. Right over here, and you see that as soon as you have got a lot of surface area like those filaments that you have over here, then the more algae you have, and this serves again as a place for other organisms to grow on, like those diatoms, right? So it's kind of a little bit also like a vicious cycle here, and I think it becomes very clear that if you just look at this dense network of filamentous algae over here, I mean, they take a lot away a lot of light for the plants. Look how dark it is over here, right? So the more algae you have, the less light the plants will get. And it's also, of course, something that reduces then the plant growth. So basically, that's the first thing that I would try, reduce the nutrients. And you can also exchange the water more frequently, because by exchanging the water of the aquarium a little bit more frequently, not too much, at once, the fish might not like that, right? But if you keep on exchanging the water more frequently, then also this pushes down the number of nutrients in the aquarium. And of course, what you want to do is the first thing is you want to cut away all of those plants that are kind of fuzzily overgrown by algae. Just want to show you something now. Yeah, look at this here. These are basically some of the leaves of plants that I gathered from the aquarium. And look at this here. I mean, just if you take this out here, look, it's totally slimy, and there are algae growing on here. And of course, this plant's gonna die, and this or this leaf's gonna kind of start to be decomposed, and also by bacteria. Look at this here, right? a decomposing plant material again releases nutrients. So what you want to do is you want to remove all of those plants that kind of are hopelessly lost already. Yeah, look, all of these algae overgrowth here that you've got. Yeah. You gotta remove all of them as well. Otherwise, you have yet more nutrients in the aquarium water, then essentially you have again this vicious cycle where you then have yet more algae growing. But let's go back here again. Yeah, so these are, yeah, so how it looks like. And basically what I've also seen is occasionally, I mean, like over here, occasionally you do see a little bit of movement of other microorganisms in here, but generally there were not so many of those because when you, I think that's when you take out the leaves with those algae growing on it, of course, then any single-celled microorganisms are going to be washed away, and then they're not going to be visible anymore because they're going to be washed away into the water. But I have seen a couple of worms already here as well. You see over here some tiny microorganisms as well, right? Yeah, so and one mistake that I basically made when I set up my first aquarium was that I added a nice root of a tree as a decorative element into the aquarium, and this really destroyed the water quality. The water turned all red because of the pigment of this root, and an algae started to explode, of course, because in this piece of wood there was so many nutrients in there that essentially was basically fertilizing the aquarium, this way. And it's of course something that you don't want to do. What I should have done is, before adding the piece of wood into the aquarium, I should have actually boiled it. Really, you have to boil it, and this kind of leaches out all of those nutrients, and then it's going to be much safer to be used in the aquarium, right? So that's basically something that I've tried, and with more or less success. But there was actually one thing that really improved the quality of my aquarium, and that was I had to add some carbon dioxide to the aquarium, and this really promoted the growth of plants. And how did I do that? Well, I've taken a plastic container and I fill it up with water. I added sugar and a small amount of yeast. And then the yeast started to ferment the sugar and made CO2. And I used a tube, an air tube, and I basically caught the CO2 gas and put it into the aquarium over the air tube. So I did not only have the air pump bubbling through the water, but I also added extra CO2 into the aquarium, and this really made the plants happy because then they started to grow quite nicely, right? And when the plants grow well, then algae also have a problem because the plants will then also remove a lot of nutrients, and then algae will also have a problem. Yeah, and then last but not least, one of the things that you might want to try is you might also want to maybe reduce the amount of light. Definitely do not allow sunlight to shine into the aquarium, because this is going to be not only cause maybe an overheating of the aquarium, it's generally not good, but this will also significantly promote the growth of algae. And so reduce the amount of light a little bit. And sometimes it can be that sensitive that even by changing the color of the light, okay, and this can also have an impact on plant and algae growth. So that's also something that you might take into consideration. So you see, it's a complex ecosystem, multiple measures are probably necessary to control algae growth here. But I have to tell you, as a hobby microscopist, I don't mind that too much, because look, I mean, there's always something interesting to discover. Essentially, occasionally you do find a couple of interesting microorganisms in here as well. Maybe not so much in this sample here, but there's a little bit of movement going on here, right? In any case, it's always something quite interesting to be found in a more or less complex ecosystem, right? Like an aquarium. Maybe you also have some recommendations. Please do share them. I would like to, of course, also like to invite you to subscribe to this channel if you're interested in microscopy related videos. But that's basically all from my side that I would like to share with you today. I wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting as always. See you around in the next video. Bye-bye.